Okay, everyone, we are doing live streaming right now at this point. Somebody should need to talk about.
Well, let's see how many people. Can you see how many people are in?
Nobody right now.
Let's wait until people are actually here.
Is it even working?
I think so. Let's see it. Are we on the gudsen?
Yes, we are.
What is it, like a delay?
There's a delay, huge delay.
Wow, because I'm over here and I see myself.
Oh, wow.
And it says it's live.
One viewer.
Semi-live.
One viewer. Well, it should say on the iPhone, right?
Yeah, it's one viewer right now.
We have one person.
What's up, one viewer? We're waiting for a couple more people to come in, and then, you know, right now we're just getting a bunch of B-roll shots of the crane and the MOZA Air. And, you know, once we get a couple more people in, we'll kind of start talking about what we're going to do today.
Two people.
What's up, number two? Just waiting for some people to show up.
I just added, like, 10 different people to the group, so who knows?
Three people.
Four.
Good morning. Feel free to type into the comments where you guys are from. We are currently residing in Cleveland, Ohio. This is where this test is being taken place. So it is, what time is it?
It is 10:30.
10:30. So if we got any West Coast people, sorry that you're up this early watching.
Edgar said good morning.
Good morning. Edgar?
Yes.
Good morning, Edgar.
Three people now. One just left.
Nothing's going on.
Devin is in Vegas. Edgar is in Washington, D.C.
Oh, hey.
Four people.
Cool. D.C. is not too far. What was it? Did it take us 6 hours or 7 hours to drive to D.C.? That one time, Johnny?
It's the same time frame.
No, I know. It wasn't that far from Cleveland, though. It was like
six hours and a half. Mm.
But good morning to Vegas. Who is in Vegas?
Got more people. Vegas is Devin. And
nice.
Ryan just joined. He's from Norton, MN. Mm.
Minnesota. Yeah. Shout out to Minnesota. I'm from Iowa originally, so.
Whoever you see in the camera, that's Jason. That's not me. Five people.
Las Vegas. That's like 3 hours behind us.
Yeah, the light in the background, I want to move a little bit just because it's giving a hot spot on the gimbal.
Where do you want
to... Oh, yeah, that way too. What camera do we have on the gimbal right now?
We currently have... This is the A7S, first generation, not two. And over here we have the Canon 70D.
Well, there's a delay. Huge delay.
That's okay.
So and you're going to answer the question.
Yeah, we'll answer.
30 seconds.
Yeah, so there is a lag between what we see the questions and when we answer them. So
we got Alex from Hong Kong.
Really?
Hey, Alex. He's a cool guy. Huh? He also have a pre-production unit.
Oh, Alex.
Alex from time-lapse. I need a chair.
I guess it's nighttime over there right now, right?
Yeah.
Why not?
It's not late.
Yeehaw, Alex. And of course, we'll also have the GH5 on our test setups as well.
And
we will be doing one with the image stabilization, including the in-body stabilization, plus the lens, and then of course we'll turn all that off so you guys can see the raw footage of how the GH5 handles it as well. The A7S obviously does not have any stabilization, so that's going to be the raw footage as it is. And then for the 70D, we do have the lens optical stabilization, which we'll do on and turn off as well.
This is at the current length of 20, or is it?
Just saying no.
No?
Yeah. because that seems to do pretty well, as far as the stabilization goes. Any other questions coming in, or Vita, or anybody?
No problem with the delay. What's the heaviest test combo you've run?
The heaviest test combo, it might have actually been the GH5 with a 35mm Rokinon. But if we were to test out the heaviest one, it'd probably be the 35 Rokinon on the Canon 70D.
Yeah. Just how we probably may want to see the gimbal too.
Are we going to be able to take, were we planning to take the Facebook Live outside?
Yes, that one okay.
That one can?
Yes. Okay. That's where the everything else. I'm recording here too, so I should give you a wireless mic, but right now we're not going to deal with that.
Yeah, because we're just getting ready for testing.
Okay.
Seven people.
Cool. Are you?
There's no, is there any delay, like the heaviest test combo you have run?
I already told them what's the heaviest one, but the heaviest one that we can do today is probably the 70D plus the Sigma. That would be the heaviest setup we have.
And the lightest is the...
The lightest is the A7S with the
30mm?
16mm. And that's a cropped sensor lens, so it's not a full frame.
Correct.
All right. So, are you going to do a test first, or what we have there? We have a...
Sorry, I told them. We have a Canon 70D.
I mean the gimbal.
We have the crane. That's with the Canon 70D right now. And then the MOZA has the A7S.
Can you show the rear view of the Sony, wondering how much of the viewfinder you can see?
Sure.
It's a delay.
Yeah. But as long as you can tell from there, yeah, can they see it?
There is not real time.
Yeah.
Here,
well, I just want to make sure that they can see. Well, here, can you move this up so it's almost eye level?
Turn it on. Okay.
Well, as long as we know that the live is doing its thing.
What do you say?
Oops.
He was worried, but it should be okay. So, what are we going to do here? You can explain what we're trying to do. We're going to do a comparison and do two gimbals and each camera on each in one of those gimbals.
Okay. How many people do we have?
Seven.
Seven? Okay. All right.
Eight.
It keeps climbing.
Okay, that's good. All right. So for the people that are already joining us, so today we're trying something completely new. We're doing a live stream of basically our big review, in-depth review of the Zhiyun Crane and the MOZA Air. So at any time, if you have a question, you can pop it down in the comments and... Our team is going to tell me if there's a question that we should answer, and I will, of course, answer it as best as I can. But today, basically, what we're going to do is we're going to do a huge test between these two gimbals. We have an A7S, the lightest camera of the bunch,
yes.
And we have the GH5, the new GH5, which is a little bit heavier than the GH4, but, you know, it's pretty good. And then the heaviest camera we have is the Canon 70D. We don't have a Canon 5D Mark II, unfortunately. But
we have a few questions here. Xavier also asked about, with the GFI, do you have to flip out or not?
Yes. When we do our tests, we will have the screen flipped out. We did an action shoot this weekend, and that's how all the gimbals were being ran, so that the camera operator can see what it is that they're filming.
10 people.
Let's see what else. So basically what we're going to do today is we're trying the lightest camera all the way to the heaviest camera. And what we're trying to figure out is, you know, how well do they work with the different weight classes of cameras. Now, with the GH5 and the Canon 70D, the GH5 we're going to do with in-body stabilization and optical stabilization, which is their, what was it called? What was their dual? I think it's just dual IS.
Dual IS.
Yeah, dual IS. We will have that on because for people with a GH5, why not? But of course, we'll also show it without any stabilization whatsoever, so you can see the raw performance of each camera. And just to know, the Sony A7S with the cropped lens here, it doesn't have any image stabilization whatsoever, so there is no, that will only just be one footage as far as the testing goes.
According to Gudsen, the MOZA Air will be shipped Monday.
Okay.
Oh, in general, to everybody?
Yeah.
Okay.
Someone said, in, I'm not familiar with the 26-30-50 batteries, but will the gimbal take the 1865 battery, or 650 batteries?
Yeah. No, the Air already comes with that one type of batteries.
Yeah, or Zhiyun uses that battery, I think, the 1865.
I think so.
Stand by.
Zhiyun.
So the answer for the battery question that was just posed, the Zhiyun Crane, the one over here, uses the 18650 battery. And the MOZA Air version that we have, it uses the 26350. So if you take a look at it, there's a length difference as well as how thick the battery actually is.
So are you going to run each one of them first, or are you going to have somebody else run the other one?
Who has the least experience with gimbal running here?
Both of them. Let them do it.
Okay. So we'll, yeah. Well, I mean, well, we can, should we do two tests?
Yeah.
Between an experienced person and a non-experienced?
Well, not a bad idea.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, so guys, what we're going to do today is we do have two crew members who haven't had extensive hands-on with this. So what we're going to do is we're going to do two tests. And I don't know if we should do it for every setup. Maybe just with ones that don't have stabilization?
Yeah.
Okay. So the cameras that don't have stabilization, we'll make sure in the final review, we'll let you know that this is the experienced person and that this is the least experienced person. We'll probably do that with the A7S since it's already on here, and it's the one camera we know that doesn't have image stabilization. So, well, actually, I take that back. We should do one with a heavy camera and a lighter camera because it's going to be different. So
that one's heavy.
Yeah,
the Nikon D750. But they're both already there, so all you have to do is just set it up.
Yeah, we just have to make sure we crop through everything. Any other questions coming through the comments?
No, but Ryan thanked us for showing the back of the screen of the A7S.
You're very welcome, Ryan. All right, how many viewers are we hitting?
So we're at 10.
10?
We jump between 10 and 11.
Cool.
Do you have to turn off the switch over? Or?
I am not entirely sure if I can accomplish that.
You talking about Ken?
Huh?
Stabilization, full frame, you said
it's extremely
heavy. For any Nikon filmmakers, we do have a Nikon here too that we're going to give it a try as well. Pretty much hitting every gamut.
Why is that focusing?
Well, you're at 100 mil.
Are you you still have the variable frame rate?
Yeah. Well, it's off now.
Okay. Because for the B-roll, we had it turned to 60 frames. So you could pull it back to 24.
All right. So are you? We're going to do... Who's going to do first? You do first, and then did somebody else do?
Do what first?
Walking with a gimbal.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm going to do it first?
Yeah, who gonna, I mean, doesn't matter. You or him.
Okay.
Doesn't matter.
Which one?
Oh, let's do the MOZA Air. Mm-hmm. Oh, we're going to switch the camera anyway to the gimbals.
We have to switch it.
Where am I going
to
walk?
Should we do the inside first and then outside?
Can you open the lights on the green screen room?
So we'll go ahead and
So stand by.
Stand by. Or why don't you put... are we going to go upstairs through the hallway?
Yeah, you head and set up, disable the alarm.
All right, we'll be right back.
So meantime, we're waiting. There's more questions?
Yeah.
They're just watching.
Okay.
So I'm going up the stairs, you said?
Yes. He's setting everything upstairs, so stand by. I gotta bring the. No.
Leave it?
Yeah, you can leave it there.
I'm gonna bring the power to the doctor in case we need it.
Okay. It says you're running pre production units with 4 batteries, and the regular unit will have 3, right? So that means the battery life. Oh, man, it stopped. Somebody asked a question, but it's a long question.
What's the question?
Oh, yeah. Oh, we got another one.
What's the questions?
Please show this thumb controller too.
Yeah, we'll do the thumb controller a little bit later. Right now, the thumb controller do not have the latest firmware, so we will talk about that when we do the actual review. Just bear with us a little bit. Yes.
You want to unlock the conference room door that goes upstairs.
Good point.
We'll have to turn on all those lights so we make a loop all the way around.
So what's that total weight of the camera tested, please?
The total weight?
Yeah.
MOZA Air can go 5.5.
No,
so
I think
only 3.9.
I think they want to know the actual weight of the camera.
I would. That's.
We don't.
You might have to wait till the full review. What about a
well,
total?
If they just do a quick online search of the body.
It says your pre-production unit runs with 4 batteries, and the regular unit will have 3, right? So it means that the batteries will have
a shorter life.
Shorter. I'm assuming that's just continue shorter life because it just stops. It says shorter.
Or sorry, for which one? For the MOZA or the Zhiyun?
They didn't specifically say. That was Xavier.
I have a question here. How much does the thumb controller cost?
Thumb controller.
Hey, Johnny, how much does a thumb controller cost?
Which one?
Thumb controller? For
probably MOZA.
For MOZA, it's $199, but it's on their website.
Yeah. For pricing information, check out their website. That will be the quickest way, because today we're just going to be more or less talking about, you know, the cameras and what you want to see on it. So those kind of information we would say, if you
The MOZA
disclaimer: we do not work for MOZA. We do not work for Zhiyun. This is literally an independent test of both systems.
Any demo for dual handle movement? I believe it's in.
We'll probably get to that later.
Okay.
All right. But you can suggest why.
Oh,
we
dual
do
handle movement. I think he means that. Yeah.
So who want to walk in front?
What?
We need someone to follow.
Oh, I'll be your test dummy.
Okay. Cool.
All right. So what we're gonna do here is we need to record also the actual footage. Right now we're gonna use the MOZA Air by a filmmaker who had used this before.
Up is starting to rumble again.
So if you hear the rumble noise, you basically had to go. You hear the noise? That's also because of the profile is different. So we had to go into the change of profile.
Go ahead. Does someone want to hold it for John? Or hold the gimbal, I mean. Or
MOZA
something.
Whoa. Go to camera.
Just
There you go.
Boom.
No more noise.
Now, everybody's questions, we know they're popping up, but while we're running each test, we'll answer your questions when we get back through the loop.
Okay, somebody asked which one we would choose. We're actually going to keep both of them because we really like both of them a lot. So it's up to you what you want to do.
All right, it's loading.
All right, here we go.
Upstairs.
Yep.
Yep.
And I'm using the MOZA Mini C to follow them.
Door.
Oh, okay.
It's not unlocked.
Oops. Stand by.
I don't think I have the key to unlock.
It's the master key.
Hide the code.
Alright.
No. Why don't you guys go back down to the bottom? Because basically what I'm going to do...
Run the test one more time.
Yeah, you're going to go...
Go to the conference room.
Stand by, I'm gonna go set up everything.
Okay.
You can keep recording. Well, you can stop. He's gonna stop recording.
Fit in here,
oh, so you have to go to the other side, open it then.
I think
I keep it on, or I keep it on.
Take two.
Because it seems like
hold on, Johnny, because I think on the other side is also a dead hole.
I opened it before, so yeah.
A double check. Stand by, guys. We need to make sure we have the whole route opened. Welcome, Klaus.
For you guys to know, the MOZA controller is $199 online, or that's what it's showing online. So, figured you guys wanted to know.
Meanwhile, we're just chilling. Cool. Yeah, it's definitely a lag.
Somebody asked why should filmmaker get the MOZA over the other one.
Stand by.
All right, we had to go this way and come back down this way. I don't have the key to unlock that door.
Okay. That's
so
weird.
Go circle ahead and go back up there.
Or should we just go this way?
Yeah,
is there
could.
Stairs going
yeah.
up that way?
There's stairs up there.
Yeah.
All right, we're doing it from this point. I can sit here and do this.
What's my path?
So we're going to go through the dressing room, through the conference room, up the stairs, through parts of the hallway, turn back around, and come back down this
okay.
way. So we will
correct me if I start going over.
Okay. All right, here we go. This is the A7S on the MOZA Air with an experienced cameraman. Here we go. And take a right up the stairs.
left. Keep to the left. Sorry. Oh no, I guess there's no lights there. Sorry, go down this way. Once we hit the kitchen, we'll loop back the other direction.
Alright.
Sorry.
So we're just gonna repeat this path for each test. All right, go ahead and turn that off, and then we'll set that back.
Can you turn the MOZA off?
Not yet, because now we're gonna have Dennis do the operation or Vitas.
Okay.
For a least experienced mover.
All right.
Okay, so that was the A7S with on the MOZA Air with an experienced gimbal runner. So now we're gonna do Vitas, who has the least experience with it. We're gonna walk the same path, and in the final review, we'll have a look at what it looks like.
What just happened?
You didn't turn
off, record.
Did
you? I hit record while holding it.
That's fine.
Okay, and you guys are doing this.
Yeah, that way you give extra grip.
Okay, which one am I walking?
Following me.
Yep, just follow him. Go ahead.
There's only a small chance I'll get one.
Bend the knee a little bit so you don't have to have the problem with cut, you know.
Been a little blurry here.
Oh, for it.
Ready?
It's hard to know which one you're first putting up.
Yeah, watch the step.
Don't let me forget that.
Remember, there's a step on the other side.
Fun.
and stop recording. Turn this one
down to 5.
We're going to bring the other big TV screen. Somebody can run the second one.
Yep.
Then we have to switch cameras.
So while the second camera is being ran, I'll set up the GH5.
Okay.
On this one.
Well, you can explain.
Okay. All right, so we just ran two tests with the A7S on the MOZA Air, one with an experienced gimbal user and one with the least experienced user. So that does it for this camera on this gimbal. We're going to move that over later. But the next run test we're going to do is a Canon 70D, and it's got an 18 to 35 lens on it. Now, this one does have image stabilization. So what we're going to do is we'll do the first one with it off. And we'll do the same test again, one with an experienced gimbal runner and one with an inexperienced. So
it.
While that's happening, I am going to switch the A7S off, and we're going to put the GH5 on the MOZA Air.
I think
I'm going to
bring the
black.
There is, but I'm not using the black right now.
I'm looking there here.
I don't think it matters.
Okay, I'll just do it here. Cable. It does matter.
Oh god. There's your finger. Got a good look at that.
You love making them all scream, huh?
Alright.
Didn't I shut out a fridge then? I
think so. Have you guys done that before?
Alright, press it. Yep.
Alright, cool.
Here we go.
Here?
This is much heavier.
Go ahead, follow them.
You okay?
Yep.
Alright.
This time I'm going to put the peanut butter back in the fridge.
Yeah, there you go.
Ready?
Yep, I'm ready. Yeah, I have so many shots of Dennis walking to the fridge.
Canon 70D, image stabilization off with experienced gimbal runner. And stop recording. Alright. Vitas, do you want to do the walking this time and Dennis can
sure.
run the gimbal?
Yes, Dennis, you run the gimbal.
Oh, jeez.
Okay. Well, so Keith, you'll follow. All right, this is the Canon 70D with an inexperienced gimbal runner.
You'll be the runner.
Hold on. It's getting hot.
You'll be
oh,
walking.
I'm
going to
walk.
Yep,
okay.
You're going to walk the same path.
I wanted to.
Okay. All right, you're ready to go.
Is it recording already?
Yeah, I already said it.
Okay. Do the walking for
hold.
Is that?
Somebody asked what lens is used on the A7S. It's a 16 millimeter lens for the A7S. You gotta start running at the end.
What?
So you gotta start running at the end, boy. We're at 8 now.
Should I stop recording?
Yes, yes, please.
Mm-hmm. Just be put back in or?
Don't know.
Johnny?
Plug it to the power. Are you gonna plug it? Or
yeah,
you plug it back in?
Okay. Looks like it's gonna go crazy on me.
Have you ever tried putting a BMCC on the gimbal as shown in the promo video?
No, we have not. We actually don't have access to that camera, unfortunately. But if we had to guess, it's probably a little bit lighter than this. And what we've noticed is that because the A7S is so light, because it doesn't achieve perfect balance, right, Keith?
No, it doesn't.
Okay, it doesn't achieve the perfect balance, but because it's so light and the motors are strong enough, it's able to still stabilize it. So we're going to assume that for the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera, that it will also balance. Wait, was it the Pocket Cinema camera or the Cinema camera?
That's Cinema.
Oh.
Well, that was much bigger, too.
Yeah,
he said, is it even possible for the gimbal to handle that camera properly?
You know, without testing it, but just based on seeing that camera, it's so wide and square. I'm going to assume that you might not be able to. But wait, they said they saw it on promos?
Yeah, so as shown in the promo photo.
Mm. It's possible they could, but we don't know.
There's a link.
Yeah,
it's possible they could.
Yeah, they do have a Blackmagic in this picture.
Okay.
They sure do.
For the Zhiyun Crane or the
MOZA?
MOZA.
Okay.
That's something we can test out.
Yeah.
That's something if somebody has a...
If someone has that camera and the MOZA Air, definitely give it a test. But unfortunately, we don't have access to that camera.
Have we answered how fast can you fully charge the batteries?
5 hours.
About 5 hours.
But we bought our own charger. It charged faster. And the battery lasts 6 to 8 hours, so really not a problem.
This is the extra charger that we bought.
Does that one move faster then? Or?
Yeah, it seems to charge faster.
So this could be doing
four light C2?
Yeah.
Then this is going to be all the close out again.
Something you can find off of Amazon.
And this could be wide shot.
Okay. All right, right now we have the GH5 that's the one that's going to be going on the MOZA Air for this next test. Stand by for 1 second.
IBS on or off?
Off.
IBS off.
I believe I answered that one. Which lens used with the Sony A7S, the 16mm.
Yeah. This is when we start doing the actual review here.
Johnny, can you change the camera on the app?
Oh. Is it on?
Yeah, it's on.
We're setting the from the app to GH4, GH5. Should be. Set.
Want me to start rolling?
Yeah.
Okay. And can you bring with unplug or
okay.
Wait, unplug from there.
Yes. I already got it. I got it.
Okay, it's just gonna be hard to plug it back in.
Yeah, I know.
Just show them that we have the dual IS turned off. As you can see right here, dual IS is off, so there's no stabilization either. And the electronic video, I don't know if you can see that, guys, but the electronic video stabilization is turned off as well. So, Keith, or do you want me to run it this time?
Yeah, you can run it.
Okay.
We'll be in front. Keith can be in front.
I'm going to be in front.
All right, guys, this is the MOZA Air GH5 image stabilization turned off with an experienced gimbal runner. We're using the 12-35 lens.
Don't follow?
You do.
Okay.
All right, you guys ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go.
I think it's beautiful, guys.
Don't forget about the butter.
You get tired of walking like that?
Huh? As tired as I am from the shoot this past weekend, yes. There was a moment where it flipped for a second because I was using the thumb control when we're going down the stairs.
Oh, you're using the thumb control?
Well, otherwise I wouldn't be able to see him going down the stairs.
Okay. So. We can make sure.
You have
just
to
breaking
you
things.
Have to hold the bottom
yeah.
At all times.
Well, we'll find out, yeah.
Gimbals don't like this.
Like, he's making things I've never seen.
All right, so...
So now we need inexperienced.
Clearly.
With more. All right. Okay.
I'll walk.
So
this one's
the
one
to walk. Yeah.
Jason?
I'll walk.
You sure?
Yeah.
Then
yeah,
someone needs to put the A7S on this one.
Stand by.
Ready?
Is it recording?
Yep.
Recording. Okay. Go for it.
Take your lines first.
This is the Panasonic GH5 inexperienced gimbal runner.
I'm still really not understanding my motivation.
Wow. You're really trying to figure out where that peanut jar of peanut butter is.
And just in case anybody asks, the A7S is at a 2000 ISO, so that, you know.
You guys hear that?
Oh,
you're not able
to share
the F-stop at 2.8. No. Well, actually, there's a stop.
There's a what?
When does this stop recording? Yes.
It stopped?
Then you can share it after this is completed and upload completed as a not live. Okay. All right, you're gonna do the give the crane now.
Crane.
Oh, crane. Yeah.
The A7S.
You want to say it?
Are you recording?
Huh?
Be not here to walk with them now.
Okay, so alright guys, this is the, now we're testing the crane with the A7S, obviously no image stabilization on, this is with an experienced gimbal user.
10 people still watching.
Oh, am I walking?
Find
I am
your,
walking.
Find your motivation.
Go ahead, just go. You might as well just go.
Find my motivation as I go.
Don't forget to answer the phone.
Once again, the A7S is light as all get out.
Thank you.
didn't answer the phone.
Yeah, there's these people walking behind you. No, I'm going down some stairs. It's pretty intense.
Johnny, I killed it.
Oh, no. What happened?
What'd you do? I don't know, I got all tangled up.
This is hilarious.
Sorry, guys.
Look how dirty.
Oh, wow. It just started spinning.
Operator, do not know what to do with the camera and gimbal. Every time he touches mini C, he destroys it.
Alright, Dennis, you need to do the gimbal.
Venus is already had chickens.
It's getting toasty. Oh,
yeah, those get hot. Like, I'm actually pretty impressed with them.
Which one?
These jackets.
Oh.
Come on.
Hey, Johnny, which jackets? So which one go now?
Best one, inexperienced gimbal.
Turn it on first.
That's a good idea. It's not recording.
Vidas, you'll be in front. You can run this thing.
You want me to run?
Do what?
You find that.
That's horribly placed.
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh, walking?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys, this is the A7S on the Zhiyun Crane with inexperienced gimbal runner.
Hold. And ready?
Mm-hmm.
Action.
Hopefully the phone doesn't ring.
Uh-oh. Oh, jeez. I had to skip stairs to catch up.
He's just, like, running, baby.
It's making me winded.
Man, that's pretty good. Yeah.
Man, Vegas is running.
I'm holding back. Okay, is it walking faster again?
Are you walk fast enough, buddy?
Yeah. Go like this. I had to run upstairs.
I noticed that because we were watching here, so he flew.
Jeez.
Keith was running.
He hit the stairs like a champ.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Now we're going to do the GH5 on the MOZA Air. This is with in-body stabilization and the optical stabilization turned on. So if you have a GH5, you know, this is your ideal setup, having everything on. All right.
GH5 with image stabilization on 12-35 no, experienced gimbal runner.
Who's going
really? To walk with us? Shouldn't we be recording on this or not?
Huh?
Shouldn't that... Like,
no, we're doing a review later.
Oh, okay. So this doesn't matter yet?
Yeah, that doesn't matter yet.
Who's going to be in front here?
Doesn't matter.
I will.
That is love to be in front.
I'm going
to
slow it down.
Yeah.
Stand by.
Super inexperienced gimbal. Person.
Give yourself some slack.
Right. Holding this.
Give yourself some slack. So that way you don't pull it.
Alright.
Ready?
And ready.
We're good. We're good.
I'm just going to go full sprint.
Let me tell you why I'm tired, Johnny. Because I'm literally walking like this the whole time.
There's a difference when you're the tall one.
Yeah. Trust me, I know.
Yeah, when you're a tall gimbal operator.
So we're actually having a Zhiyun here. I'm Johnny, this is Jason, by the way. on the Nikon on the Zhiyun, which is, you're not supposed to, but it's working. So.
Yeah.
But before we get to that one, inexperienced gimbal runner with... in body stabilization, dual IS, the whole deal on the MOZA Air.
Alright, who's gonna go?
Janetis.
Jimmy?
Oh, no. Who did this last time?
I think I've only touched this one.
So was it you that did this one last time?
The MOZA...
Because we want to keep it same.
I did.
The same operator.
Yeah, I think that's...
Yeah, who did the MOZA last time? Inexperienced. I thought that was you, Dennis. You sure?
I thought it was him.
Is
yeah, pretty positive.
Vitas, you're about to go.
I've done two as well.
So they've done...
Paper, rock, scissors.
I'm trying to remember.
Rock, paper, scissors. 1, 2, 3. What does that mean?
I don't know.
I guess he's going to run right. It. Then it's in front.
All right.
Keith, the mini C.
Well, no, wait. Who?
I'll walk.
Maybe it was Dennis, because you said he ran the stairs, right?
Yeah, that's now. Right. But he was using this one.
I remember seeing the record
on the A7S.
Yeah.
I haven't touched the MOZA, I don't believe.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I got 7.
We just want to make sure.
I think...
Because the A7S was on this one last.
Yes.
I've only touched the other one.
Dear God. Is that my phone?
Mm-hmm. So who do you want on that one?
I don't know. If you haven't touched the MOZA, then it must have been Venus.
Okay. So who do you want popping?
Vitas.
Okay.
We
want to
keep
yeah.
It the same.
Good.
Alright.
Okay.
Record. Alright, this is the Panasonic GH5 with all the image stabilization turned on. This is Vitas. Ready?
We are all set.
Thank you.
Okay, so next one up is the Nikon, which one is this? The
D750.
Nikon D750 with
28-100, 3.5-4.5D.
Alright, and that one's going to be on the Zhiyun Crane, and we're going to move this Canon over to the MOZA Air.
Do
we have
experience first? Or?
Yeah, experience first. But you'll probably set up the video just things because we never used it.
You just hit record right here.
Yeah, go ahead for
that. Did you want to walk in front again?
Sure.
Thank you.
Get my exercise in today.
This is record right here.
Okay. Is this on? I don't feel like it's on. Hold on.
Technically speaking, the Nikon should not work, but.
Alright, in theory, the Nikon should not be able to be stabilized on this Zhiyun Crane.
Can I record?
But we're going to give it a try.
Alright.
Recording.
Recording.
Alright, this is the Nikon on the Zhiyun Crane with experienced gimbal runner.
Oh, it's doing weird stuff. I don't know.
Maybe. Stand by.
Okay.
Yeah, it's too heavy.
Do you want to try the lighter lens? The DX lens?
No, it's the camera.
Is it bouncing?
No, it's not bouncing, but it was acting like I wanted to do it. Alright, we'll go for it. We'll go
for it. Alright, here we go. I'm going to give it a try.
Ready?
It seems much more floaty. Alright, I'm ready.
Alright.
Definitely heavier.
I got a little silver brain.
Not bad.
Was it acting up a little bit or?
No, it didn't act up at all. But it definitely heavier. Much heavier.
All right, so that was the Zhiyun Crane on the Nikon.
Experience.
And now we head to the inexperienced.
Dennis or Vitas?
That one's,
probably me.
You're on that one, I'm on that gimbal.
Oh, you're doing this gimbal?
Yeah, so anything on that gimbal is yours.
Okay.
Alright, Dennis.
Dennis, Vitas in front.
Records on Keith. Tap.
See.
Oh, I'm walking.
In the mini seat. Vitas, don't run.
Yes, Vitas.
That's for the outside test. When we're
don't
running.
Run.
Are we doing an outside test on this camera?
That's right.
For those kind of things, but like,
huh? Running. Oh, I'm ready.
Great, let's go. Okay. Maybe the GFI.
Will you pretend like you're like an old.
Let's just do it
without. Okay, a little too
soft. He's gonna watch this.
watch me right now.
I don't think he has audio right now.
Oh, that's good.
Your punishment will be delayed.
Okay, one step.
Yeah, that one's a little heavier.
Of course,
so I'll run this Canon one, and then we need to balance the GH5
okay, I can take care of that.
On that one.
On
onto this one.
Okay.
Keep you can balance that. Yeah. Because we'll be running it outside. My phone.
Can you turn that to the Canon?
Sure. So you want to talk a little bit too?
Okay, so we just took off the Nikon D750 off of the Zhiyun Crane. So this one is going to eventually make its way over to the MOZA Air. Right now on the MOZA Air we have the Canon 70D. And we're going to run with the experienced gimbal runner.
Is it light?
Medium, probably.
You want to hack it?
Sure.
It's lighter.
Should be okay.
Okay. All right.
So who's doing the walking?
I guess I...
Oh, okay. I just gave him the gimbal. Okay.
Actually, let's switch. I
want to. You want to do this? Okay.
I want to break gimbals now.
Alright, this is the Canon 70D maybe. On the MOZA Air. It's experienced
camera.
Right?
Nope, I'm not. There we go.
Experienced camera.
What lens are you using?
Which one?
The one right now.
18 to 135.
Okay, great.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, go.
I think
can run the A7 if you can keep up.
That's for when we're outside.
Oh God. Bad things are happening. Let's hold for a moment. And there we are. Things got a little dicey at the top of the stair.
I think it's because of that cable. If you like turn it too much.
Oh, so Johnny has all his stuff inverted, which drives me nuts.
No. I didn't have it inverted. That's come that way.
Yeah.
Oh. It's inverted.
You can't, can you change it?
Yes, you can. I just have it. You know, planes like that too, you know that, right?
Yeah, that's why I don't fly planes.
You go downwards, you actually go upwards. Is it upwards?
No, right now this is not inverted.
Yeah, maybe it needs to be inverted. I don't know. Whatever it is, it needs to be the opposite.
For me, I need it inverted because of all video games and stuff. it throws me off completely.
Yeah.
So right now would this mess with you or no?
It does.
Okay.
Right now the standard is not inverted. And I press down and it goes down. I'm like, no, I need to go up.
All I know is it's the opposite of what I expected it to.
Yeah,
so, like, when I was on the stairs, I think I bumped it, and then trying to fix it, it just got worse and worse, and I'm like, oh, God.
So we're done with the...
Not yet. We need an experienced...
Which is Vetus.
Vetus.
Oh, you might want to see what this is that we're playing around with.
Okay, this one?
Yes. Okay. You had to turn on the camera recording.
Yeah, okay.
It's on, just needs to be recording.
Is there a button that you press for a shovel?
No, I don't think it works like that on the Canon.
Oh, the Canon.
The start and stop, yeah.
It's a circle.
It's
yeah.
Right here.
Oh, okay, yeah.
The one
I forgot
the record
that's
button.
That's the Canon, the GF5.
Nope. Is it recording?
Yes, it's recording.
All right, this is the GH5. No. Sorry, this is the Canon 70D on the MOZA Air inexperienced runner.
Right?
Yep.
Thank you.
What?
Oh my god, we only had two people left.
Oh god.
We're losing people. What? Jason's boring.
Jason dance.
Ha! Hold it. Understandable, because they're not getting to see that.
Yeah. Might have been cool if you set up like an external monitor.
Oh yes.
And just pointed it at the monitor when we moved.
Well, we may or may not review it. Okay, so now we need to get the Nikon onto. We're going to get the Nikon onto the MOZA Air.
Okay.
And I guess I'll run this one again, the change. Or do you want to run the GH5?
Doesn't matter. That was going to balance or go. Doesn't matter.
Okay, I'll just have you balance it. Okay, so now we're going to use the Zhiyun Crane with the GH5 with the image stabilization turned off. This thing is
heavy. Sorry, it's all about that glass.
All right, Dennis will run the... Again, guys, if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments.
You only had two people.
Two people still count. All right, here we go. This is the MOZA. Sorry, this is the Zhiyun Crane GH5. You're walking, Venus.
Okay.
This is with image stabilization turned off experience gimbal runner. Here we go.
Four people now.
We are at two viewers.
There's no Nikon option on the
camera.
Okay.
With a light lens in order to get this.
Well, I've seen that if you wanted to use that lens, it's really light, but the DX.
If it's reading that as light, then I'd rather just read that.
Okay.
Just. You're up for that one.
Jimmy?
Yep.
Okay.
And then, I don't remember who was walking for you.
Does it... It is, probably.
Okay. Keith, you want to grab this one?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Go ahead and hit record. Recording?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, guys. This is the Zhiyun Crane GH5
No image stabilization. Inexperienced gimbal runner.
So there's no Nikon app.
The camera guy?
Screen share button, I'm not sure why.
Okay.
Yeah.
You might have put your face near, or it might have read as the face
coming. It might have been close to the gimbal arm.
Right. So it read. So it read like I was coming close to the eyepiece.
Be the default.
Man, you came back too fast. This is still upstairs.
That's Venus.
Venus is running.
Only two viewers.
I wonder if one of those are us.
Probably.
No, we don't count as viewers.
Oh, okay.
Well, it might.
Because technically that's you're right there.
Oh, yeah, you're right. So it's only one viewer.
Hi.
That's fine. All right, now we're going to do the Zhiyun Crane with the image stabilization turned on. I guess I'm following Vitas again. All right, here we go. This is the GH5 with Zhiyun Crane image stabilization, and everything is turned on.
For hold for Dennis.
Hold for the crowd.
Hold for
Dennis.
This guy.
Hold for Dennis. So.
Stand by.
Okay, so after that, that's it, or we have one more?
Nikon.
That's it. That's the last one.
Okay. But then we got to run with these yeah. Honkers.
But Ronnie will be with the GH5.
Huh?
Ronnie will be with the GH5. Oh, no, it's still the decision.
Well, we should run with the Sony because that's the lightest.
Okay, that well. And the lightest.
It is just us now.
Huh?
It's just
that's
us.
Fine, whatever. Here we go. Ready? And go.
Sounds like it's coming down hard.
For the weather, man.
Okay, clean the counters, play with the basket, look in the freezer. I find it nice for it, I swear.
We got a viewer. Franz is still here. Franz.
Is his last name start with an S? It's Franz something?
No, it's Franz Bischoff, I believe.
Feel free to ask any questions that you may have, Franz.
trying to do this, you guys still coming down the steps.
It's raining outside?
Yeah, pretty hard.
Oh, so I guess we can go outside.
You can wait. We have to do the test.
Okay. We'll do the test later, but we can do the review now.
Hold on. We still have non-experienced with stabilization on.
Woo!
All right. Go ahead and record when you're ready. Alright, this is the GH5 full image stabilization on the Zhiyun Crane inexperienced runner, whenever you guys are ready.
You got one viewer.
You!
Okay.
Franz.
Franz is still here with us. Oh, we got another one. We're up to three.
Franz and friends.
Franz and friends. I know we're at the boring stuff right now, but we'll get to the actual review in a second. Not a second, a few minutes. Maybe an hour. I'll just keep adding more minutes. Alright, that concludes the GH5's run. Last one is the Nikon on the MOZA Air. And then if the rain is holding out, we'll do a quick run test with the A7S because it's the lightest. And then we'll run with the GH5 image stabilization turned
on and off.
On and off. And we're not going to get to the Canon 70D and such, because we just wanted to test as far as like the lightest camera setup to almost pretty heavy. So
is it on yet? I mean the gimbal, is the gimbal on?
It's blinking. Blinking blue?
Yeah. This would
be the heaviest one really. That's the
heaviest one we have? Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, so we had to use the Canon profile because there is no Nikon profile on the app. And using the lightest weight?
Yeah, the lightest lens setting.
I think Keith is walking this way.
It was the lightest lens setting with the Canon
profile.
I'll be your person.
So that's basically the...
Beat us.
That's basically the 5D Mark III, right?
Go break this up.
Alright, this is the Nikon D750 on the MOZA Air with experienced gimbal runner.
I gotta move down out of the way because we don't need to show that yet. We're gonna show the gimbal. This on the
Well, let's take a look at what the running is doing. Ready? We have to do the running with this thing anyway, so.
4 viewers or 3 viewers?
You!
3. We have Terry that joined.
What did you say?
Just as it joined.
Oh.
How bad?
It got pretty bad. Now, because I had to shift it upward, as you were going up, and when I brought it back down, it like gave in.
I got you.
More than likely weight. It always seems to go a little bit to the right, or sorry, left, when I pressed up.
What? Every time, man.
He's the only person to
I tilt it forward too much.
Yeah.
But well, I tilt it and it doesn't.
No one has made it scream.
I tilt it from time.
I'm pretty sure every gimbal you've made scream too.
All right, last one. Nikon, inexperienced user.
This one? No.
The MOZA Air, that one. So Vitas.
Okay. It is much heavier.
Mm-hmm. All right, Keith. Are you recording?
Yep. Okay. Alright, this is the Nikon on the MOZA Air, inexperienced user, using the Canon 5D profile.
Everybody ready?
I'm ready.
Oh.
Ah, Keith.
Oh, no.
Wait, that was Keith?
Yeah, it was me.
It's still upset from having to be used.
I'm like, what?
I think the battery's gone.
Okay.
Just turn it off.
It just died. Oh no. It died on me. Johnny's like, I think it's going out, LOL. Oh no, I gotta turn it off.
Do you have the battery for it?
I'm turning it off. I'm essentially going handheld at this point. It just stopped on us. I the power, I think, went.
You power it off?
I turned it off. I'm actually handheld right now.
You know this thing. You turn it back on?
Here, okay, I'm going to turn it back on.
Well, we broke the eardrums of three viewers.
Oh. It's okay now.
Interesting.
Face all way, not face me.
All right, we can turn off the gimbals.
It's a cable.
Can't wait to watch this.
Sorry, guys.
We're having technical difficulties.
Turn this off here.
Yeah. Please stand by. Oh, there we go. Oh, yeah. That's some Cloverfield stuff right there.
Tell your boss.
Jason's face, like right before it went crazy, like he just looked upset.
What did Frank say? Let me play you a song. Ah, how nice of him.
You know, you're about to do your
yes.
Do you want me to just change this mode out to the A7S? Since we're not doing that one anyway.
Well, once the weather holds up, we're going to run with it, so
okay.
We might well, as well.
Either the battery, this battery, I did not charge, or went out of battery.
Because it sounded like the battery, I felt like the battery was going
out. Yeah, it's battery went out. Battery went out.
The battery
isn't
out?
The battery went out, yes.
Okay. Be back in
5 seconds. Sounds like every battery
does. No rain.
No rain.
We had to wait. In my computer next to the, in my office and next to my computer, there should be a clamp for an iPhone. There's a desk, recording desk. Jason, can you grab that?
The what?
You're gonna have to switch it to A7S lighting.
I need an adapter for the tripod. Or the light.
What?
On the light next to the computer in the middle, there should be iPhone adapter. Oops. Nobody want to see me.
This thing?
Yes, sir. Hey, Terry. Terry, join us.
Terry from China?
Yes. Well, he's in Vegas.
Oh, Vegas. Sorry.
He's about to go
on NAB.
Yeah, I was about to say
NAB. I want to go to that thing, but I just don't have no time for it.
I'd love to go to it. I just don't have any money.
Alrighty.
The dangerous mindset in the world.
Right. Like that just doesn't sound like a good idea.
We doing the review?
Yep.
Now, Johnny, are we just? Do we just want to? Hold on.
You were asked, will we be able to compare the footage later on with Android app?
No, that's a different thing.
You guys can talk a little bit over there.
Too busy concentrating. Okay. Johnny, need your phone.
So right now the Sony is on the MOZA Air, but you can hear some kind of you can see vibration and noise. We're using the app. Go to the camera. Select alpha, lightweight, safe, and then now it's good. Again, this is a pre-production unit, so go ahead and bear with us. You want to use microphone?
The microphone's already attached.
Is that on?
Yep.
If this is recording already.
Same.
The MOZA is actually on.
Oh, let me turn it off then.
All
All right, so we're gonna do the actual review. This is, I have the master shot. You're gonna do all the beautiful shots. And your recording microphone in.
Testing 1, 2, 3. Hi, this is Jason with MDI, and today we are doing a comparison between the MOZA Air and the Zhiyun Crane.
Stand by.
Hi, this is Jason with MDI, and today we are doing a comparison between the MOZA Air and the Zhiyun Crane.
Stand by.
Jason, do you want to answer a question?
Yes.
I have a 3-pound camera and I'm trying to decide which gimbal to buy. Your live broadcast is extremely helpful. Thank you. My question is, weight of the camera and gimbal. How tiring is it to carry each setup? And are you guys starting to get tired after this hour?
What's his name?
Mark.
Mark. Hey, Mark, what's up? Is the 3-pound camera you're talking about, is that with the lens on?
It's still jerky.
Should probably assume without. So it'd be more than 3.
Okay.
Something had to be done. I can't remember what exactly it is.
I think, in my opinion, because the Zhiyun Crane goes up to 3.9 pounds while the MOZA Air goes up to 5.5. So I would say if you're kind of on the border of it, I would probably go with the MOZA Air because of its ability to handle more weight, because you're kind of hitting the limit at the Zhiyun Crane. And there could be a time where you might have a heavier lens. So in that case, you want to have enough power to compensate. So I would say probably the MOZA Air would be what you're going for. As far as if we're getting tired from it, I can tell you this, not as tired as I used to be carrying the dual handle hanging gimbal. Like, that was very tiring to do the tests. But I can tell you that we've ran these gimbals for an extended period of time compared to how we used to use the other gimbals, and we're not tired, especially our backs. Our backs are definitely not hurting. So I would say definitely is not that tiring.
Okay, and Ryan is using a Sony A7RII with a 24-70, and he was saying it's similar, I guess, in weight.
Similar in weight? Okay. Brian, you said?
Ryan.
All right. What's up, Ryan? That's going to be a little bit harder, because I do know that that lens is quite long. If I had to guess, I would also say the MOZA Air, and the reason is because if you look to the side here, there's actually, well, you can't really tell with the GH5 here, but there's actually more back clearance compared to, this is the crane, this is the MOZA. The MOZA has a lot more back clearance, whereas the Zhiyun doesn't, and the reason there's more back clearance is because the MOZA Air is rated to go up to a 5D Mark II or Mark III. So if you're having a Sony A7R Mark II with the 24-70 lens, you're going to need as much back clearance as you possibly can to balance it. Now, unfortunately, we don't have that lens to test it on the A7S to kind of give it a little bit of a... Well, actually, do you have your EF adapter?
Look at the other side.
Stand by, Ryan.
For the
Sony.
Jason, there should be a plug.
Yeah. All right. Hold on, Ryan. This is not going to be like a real close test, but we're going to give it a shot and see if this actually works.
Just a 50 millimeter. You want just this?
Yeah, I just need to get that.
Oh, crap. You're using that lens. Plus. Can you take the tripod leg off my board?
Okay, Ryan, this is not exactly true, but this is the heaviest lens that I have. This is the Rokinon 35mm, so it's a full-frame lens. What we're going to try to do is we're going to use this adapter. Unfortunately, we can't... Well?
No, I have another one.
Do you have another one?
Yeah, I can grab the other one.
So what we're going to do is we're going to put an EF adapter onto the Sony A7S, and then we're going to pop the heaviest lens on it that we got. Maybe we might even try this one since this one does zoom out. I think the 24-75 Sony pops out a little bit, so we'll give it a try.
This one doesn't have anything.
Okay, cool. Stand by. Do you have a lens cap for your 16?
One more question before we actually go to the review.
Okay.
What does the lens say?
It happens. All right, give me a second, Ryan. Let's give this a... Let's see if we can accomplish this.
We're not going to do the mini sim today because battery's so far just ran out.
Okay.
Well, Vita's broken.
Don't you have a first one?
Yeah, but that one, by the way, I didn't even charge.
Ooh.
Here's the cool thing about this one. Put in a helmet. What is there going on? There's the batteries. Put in here. Oh, pretty cool.
Need those?
I don't think that's completely charged, too. So. Don't gosh me. Gosh.
Is anyone narrating?
Hmm?
A little bit of narration?
Right now, basically, I'm trying to see if we use the heaviest lens we got on an A7S while pulling the A7S all the way to the back, if we can achieve some kind of balance. Because I feel like that would be the one thing that could be a limitation. Because the A7S is so light. Or sorry, A7R Mark II for you, Ryan. I think it is too, but it's still quite okay. Okay, so here's what we're finding out. So right now the A7S is pulled all the way back. Okay.
Go forward if you want to.
Huh?
No, BS.
Oh, can they see?
For example,
we're still alive.
Okay. Okay, Ryan, so right now you can see this is pulled all the way back as far as it can go. And what we're seeing is that if I let go, it's going to flip forward. So I can't go back anymore to compensate for the lens's weight. Now, some people will say, well, you can use a lens collar, which is true. If I use a lens collar, I could push this back a little bit further. But then we run into the problem where your A7S body is going to knock into the yaw motor, or sorry, the roll motor back here. Now, the only thing that I can possibly think of, which we kind of have tried in the past, is we've put a quick release plate onto this plate here to give it more weight in the back. So as of right now, you can't balance a front heavy lens with a Sony body because it's too front heavy. Okay. Any other questions before we...
I think that's it.
Is that it?
Ryan didn't say more things, but I think maybe he left already.
Oh. Well.
Well, he'll come back and watch it.
Hopefully, because that was for him. can I grab your Sony lens?
Oh, no, he's there.
Oh, he's still there?
He said, thanks, awesome.
Okay. We're like, well, Ryan, where'd you go? Keith, let's put the other lens back on.
Right under the center of the counter, there should be a plug too.
No, I tell.
six people, to be consistent.
I know, we're getting to the review, guys.
All the reviews will be combined, compiled, and then we can ask those later at the end of the actual review.
Mm.
So, have the gimbals on the shot too, so people can see it. I still can't. Well, there is, but I didn't bring it. This is actually easy. You might want to see.
You just can't tilt it.
Nope, just use your hand.
You have to laugh fun.
So who's here still watching this?
Six people.
Franz is still watching. He's gonna get a star.
Yeah, he's always been here.
Cold star for Franz.
He was there when no one else was.
Yeah, no. Ryan said, this is a good real-world test. Love it. I think this is a different Ryan.
Different Ryan?
Yay.
Thank you, Ryan. Sorry we couldn't, like, promote this a little bit more. Literally, this was a last-minute thought of, like, hey, why don't we do a live stream of everything? But if this is something you guys like, next time we do something like this, we'll definitely let you all know ahead of time. So people can tune in.
Next time we probably should do it directly on YouTube.
Oh, a YouTube Hangout? Or yeah, a Google
YouTube
Hangout?
Live.
Or a YouTube Live. Yeah, we can do that.
Right, you need any more lens, or that's all good lens you need in front of you?
I mean, this is basically what we've tested.
Okay, so let's see what the camera is ready to roll.
For Zhiyun Crane is 649 and MOZA is 599, right?
MOZA is 599, yes. MOZA, however, includes all the cable line in front of you.
Dual handle, cables, and what else?
That's a thumb controller, it's separate. You might want to suggest that either company should carry one of these things.
Is there any water in there?
I think, there should be water. You want Sprite?
Oh, no water.
Hey, grapes!
That's been there.
Also grapes.
The grapes should be okay though.
Hit or miss.
I know, dim sum. That'd be great. Can't wait.
My body is ready. I'm actually hungry.
Stand by, guys. We are getting prepared to go through this review.
All right, live is ready to go, and cameras are ready. Audio is good, right?
Testing 1, 2, 3.
I don't see the level.
Oh, should I?
Where's the level thing at?
You have to turn it on. Or you hit the display button until it turns on. Testing 1, 2, 3. What's up, guys? This is Jason with MDI, and today we are going to do.
Do you want to hit it together to make it easier?
Yeah.
All right.
Three, two, one, go. Oh, wow.
Good. What's up, guys? This is Jason with MDI, and today we are doing the.
This is how it works, guys. All right. What's up, guys? This is Jason with MDI, and today we are doing an in-depth review of the MOZA Air versus the Zhiyun Crane. Now, these are both single-hand operated gimbals that have become very, very popular, and they pretty much handle a wide array of features. So today we're going to break down each one for you. What's up, everybody? This is Jason with MDI, and today we are bringing an in-depth review of the MOZA Air versus the Zhiyun Crane. Now, these are both single-handed gimbals. we need to change that. That's about to go out.
Plug it in.
Wave, Dennis.
You said stop the camera? Did you say stop the camera?
I didn't hear. Probably stop the cameras. Go ahead and
cutting.
Can you plug that with that one into?
Jason, you want to answer our question?
Sure.
Okay, so two questions. What brand and model of tripod legs are you using on those gimbals? And what brand and model of those lights are you using on each side of the table?
On each side of the table.
That's from Mark.
Mark? Mark, these little tripods are called the B-Stable Cam. Tabletop tripod, I think, right?
$15.
They're $15, and we got them off of Amazon.
The link is on my review page.
Oh, the link is actually on the review page at MDI Film. But these are all metal. And they don't. That's a train. That doesn't come with the actual gimbals itself. And what was the second question?
The model.
The model. I think it's just.
That's cool.
Just be stable cam tabletop.
Model the lights.
Tripod. Oh, those are the Came TV LED wands.
Why is that doing?
I had no idea.
Ow.
Mark said thank you.
Maybe.
Or the battery might be too low.
Maybe too low. Grab another one.
Well, we don't want the thing hanging like that, though.
Here, just grab a chair.
Yeah, it's in the closet.
Need to make sure the cell phones are off.
Both cell phones are off.
Or at least off of vibrate. I'm sorry. Mark, did I answer your questions?
You said thank you.
Thank you, Mark.
Hey, Jenny.
Yes, sir.
What's a estimated time of completion?
Well, hopefully in half an hour if it doesn't screw up. And then we can go have lunch.
So when do you think we'll be wrapped for the day?
Well, right, lunch?
Like, just in general, when you think?
2:30, to be safe.
What time is it now?
12:30. Yeah, it's battery low.
Yeah, it just needs to recharge on its own.
Show the low battery one to the people, though.
The what?
Show that one to the people so the audience can see it. Thanks.
Hold on, guys. So this is the Came TV LED wand, and what's cool about this is you have a tungsten side, you have a daylight side, there is a diffusion type layer in front of it to give it a little bit of a softer light, but it is still an LED, so if you need softer shadows, you'll probably need to diffuse it a little bit. As far as batteries go, we've probably ran these for 2 hours to 3 hours on the battery itself. It does come with a DC plug-in, so you can plug it in as well. There's also a 1/4-20 on the bottom, so you can mount it to C-stands and such. We've definitely mounted it onto C-stands, having it horizontally pointed down. You can purchase barn doors with it, so you can cut the light a little bit more. And what else? Comes in a carrying case.
With a charger.
With a charger, and I think that's really it. far as it was, it 219.
Actually, cheaper now. I'm trying to find the price right now.
Okay, stand by on the price on that one. We're finding out real quick.
Can't find it. So we'll worry about it later. I'll give you the link later.
All right, we'll post a link later, but I think it's under 200 now, maybe.
It's under 200.
Okay.
All right.
Ready?
Ready.
Hold for focus.
Mine's already, I think, focused.
Mine went out of focus because the lights were having problems. Ready?
Yep. 3, 2, 1, go.
Speed.
All right. What's up, everybody? This is Jason with MDI, and today we are giving you an in-depth review of the MOZA Air and the Zhiyun Crane. Now, these are both single-handed operating gimbals, and they have become very popular in the most recent times because everyone's either going to mirrorless or something like that, and they don't need the dual-handle type gimbals. So, without further ado, let's get started on the build quality. The build, both of them are made out of metal, so that's great. Nice, strong, powerful motors. The MOZA Air is able to handle up to a 5D Mark III at its heaviest at 5.5 pounds, whereas the Zhiyun Crane handles more of the mirrorless cameras and it can go up to about 3.9 pounds. Now, as you take a look through the actual build itself, they're relatively about the same height and overall length, but if you come down here a little bit, you'll notice that the MOZA Air has a slightly shorter handle, whereas the Zhiyun Crane has a longer handle, but the MOZA Air has a thicker handle, whereas the Zhiyun Crane has a thinner handle. In our tests, when running with these two gimbals, we didn't really notice that much of a difference between having a shorter or longer handle, and the reason is because on the bottom of both of these, there's a 1/4-20 screw. So what we've done is we've put a little tabletop tripod made by B-Stable Cam, about $15, and what we did was we can use this as an extended handle, like so, or if you wanted to, in some of the footage, you saw me have one handle out, so that it kind of gives me just a little bit more of the off-axis stabilization, whereas running with this. Another cool thing about having this attached to the bottom is if you really wanted to, you could probably achieve literally like a jib-like shot, going from all the way up here to slowly bringing it down. Now, right now I don't have the gimbal on, but that is a couple things you can do. Also, having this makes it much easier. Back in the days of the dual handle gimbals, you would need to have your own little stand to balance everything. But because of the way these single handed gimbals are built, you don't really need that. You could technically actually balance it just on the forgive me, shaft.
Stuff on the,
Where do you want me to start?
You can balance.
About balancing?
Yes.
Okay. So another reason why we've purchased these to go with the single-handed gimbals is because it makes balancing much easier. Now, back in the days of dual-handed gimbals, you'd need a separate stand. Sometimes they came with it, sometimes it didn't, so you might have to purchase it. But it kind of made it cumbersome because if you're not on a very leveled ground and... now I'm going to start over. So one of the reasons why we purchased this tabletop tripod is because not only is it portable, but it makes it a lot easier to balance your single-handed gimbal. Now, back in the day of dual-handed gimbals, you'd need to have a big cumbersome stand just to get everything ready and balanced. With this, it's portable, it's light, it's small, it has dual purpose, and it's able to be set up very, very quickly. Now, in the case that you don't have this, you can actually balance it just on the little base itself. You might want to have someone just hold it down as you're moving all the adjustments. But other than that, the build quality between these two are pretty much good. All metal, you can't complain. Now, as these two gimbals are quite similar, the price is actually quite similar too, in a sense. The MOZA Air is going to run you $599 US dollars, and the Zhiyun Crane is going to run you $649 US dollars. Now, the thing is that with the MOZA, you're actually going to get a little bit more. It does already come with all the cables for your Canon, your Panasonics, your Sony, and depending on which camera it is, you can start and stop recording with the buttons back here, as well as other plethora of options. I believe with the Canon, can you zoom?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Sorry.
With the thumb controller.
With the thumb controller, okay. Now, each different camera with the cable is going to have different set of features. Like the Panasonic, we're able to start and stop recording with the cable attached. Or with the Canon, you can start and stop recording, and you can also zoom with the thumbstick controller. So depending on which camera you have, the set of features are a little bit different. You also do get a dual handle set. I should probably show that. Stand by.
Yeah, he's at the bottom. That's for the extra, no, that's for the thumb controller.
Oh, okay.
Start out again.
Okay. Should I show the cases? Or is that B-roll?
Not necessarily. The B-roll can do the big B-roll. Okay. Dennis can do the big ones.
Okay. Did MOZA give you one of these, though?
No.
Did Zhiyun do?
Nope.
No. Okay. While these gimbals are quite similar in build, the price is actually quite similar too, but there's a little bit more to it. With the MOZA Air, it's going to run you about $599 US. With a Zhiyun Crane, it's going to run $649 US. But the MOZA is going to give you just a little bit more for that bang for the buck. First things first, they're going to give you an assortment of cables. Now, these cables are going to run from the gimbal itself into your camera, whether it be Sony, Panasonic, or Canon. Now, there is a couple features with those cables. For the Panasonic, for example, you'll be able to start and stop recording with the power button down here. If you have a Canon, you can start and stop recording, and you can zoom your lens with the thumb controller on the gimbal. Now, not all the cameras are going to be able to do the same feature set, so you'll want to take a look at the manual and see what you can actually do with it.
Actually, correction, thumb controller with a remote control.
Oh.
See the backup?
Yeah.
See that?
Oh, okay, got it.
Sorry about that.
Sorry about that. Take three. Okay. While both of these gimbals are built quite the same, there's actually similar in price as well. So the MOZA Air is going to run you $599 US, whereas the Zhiyun Crane is going to run you $649 US. But the MOZA Air does give you a little bit extra for the best bang of the buck. So we're going to start off with these cables. There's an assortment of cables here for your Panasonic, your Canon, and your Sony cameras. Depending on which brand of camera you have, you can do a couple extra features. For example, the Panasonic, you can start and stop recording with the power button here. Or if you have a Canon, you can do the start and stop recording on the button here, and there's also a rolling feature on the accessory, this wireless remote, which costs $199, and basically you'll be able to zoom your camera lens with this rolling rocker here. On top of that, you're also going to get a set of these. So remember that dual-handed gimbals that I was talking about, you can change this back into a dual-handed gimbal. So if there is a situation where you require that kind of stabilization, MOZA Air is going to have you covered on that front. Now, they all both come in a nice hard case, which I will grab and show real quick. So, so these are the hard cases that it comes with. You'll notice that, you know, it's about the same height and size, pretty small, and if you've noticed all the old gimbals, they basically came in something that was reminiscent of a Pelican case and actually a little bit bigger. So when you move to a gimbal like this, your portability is way, way up, and you're gonna be less tired hauling less gear. Now, going back to what all it comes with, they use different batteries. So the MOZA Air uses the 26 350, and you're going to need three of these to power it up. And then for the Zhiyun Crane, you're going to use the 18650s, and you're only going to need two of them. Now, I know you're going to ask, why is that one going to use three small batteries versus this one? The way these batteries are set up and how powerful these motors are on the MOZA Air, you're going to need a lot more voltage to get this thing running, whereas the Zhiyun Crane has not as powerful motors, so the voltage requirement is not as high. That's why there's two different batteries. Now, one thing that we will say, both manufacturers, while they give you a charger, they don't actually give you the USB plug that you need. Now, in the era of cell phones, probably everyone has one lying around, but it would be very nice to know that they both should include one for you. Did I miss anything? What else does the Zhiyun Crane come with besides just the gimbal and charger?
My package comes with extra set of batteries.
Okay. That's probably not the same for everyone.
No, not either. So depending on which package you buy, you can get the same.
Not
I
much
think
to
that's
say,
basically
though.
It.
That's basically it.
Yeah.
Okay. So we talked about price. We talked about what's included. Balancing. Okay. All right.
So in the article I wrote, there is four different links that mm-hmm. teach you how to balance.
Okay.
So you can do a quick review, then you can just go to the link.
Okay. Before we continue, is there any questions coming from the comments?
Any questions so far? Zero.
Zero. Okay. You guys can still ask questions. Like, well, you know, I'm not just going to spiel through this all in one go, but feel free to ask any questions along the way. Okay. Now, the balancing of these gimbals are quite similar. You have controls for going front and back on the bottom plate. And then you have another set over here to raise the cage up and down. You have another one here up top to adjust your left and right, your roll motion. And then the last one is actually down here, which is to control your yaw. Now, if you take a look at the links provided in the write-up blog, we do have a set of links to teach you how to balance these gimbals, so I would definitely check that out.
Mr. Marcus, I have a question for you.
What's up, Marcus?
Marcus.
Oh, Mark.
That's maybe it's Marcus, who knows. Hopefully you will also include how well each actually track and steady each was. Any differences?
Wait, say that again?
So it's basically how each one can track. So basically panning, lifting, and you want to know the difference between them.
Oh.
Which is better.
Okay. Honestly, both of them are the same in terms of when you turn the...
You can do that as part of the art review.
Oh.
As part of the
handling. That's part of the handling then.
Yes.
Okay, so we will get to that. Someone remind me to
okay.
talk about the track. What else did he say about the track?
That's basically how steady each one is.
How steady each one is. Okay. Okay. Someone remind me when we get to that portion. Okay, so we already talked about the balancing. iOS app, we're just going to have to shoot that separately. Because
yeah.
you have voiceover for that.
Yeah, okay.
Because
you
know the app better. But basically, okay.
You can show how that works. You want to use my phone bigger?
I don't know if you're going to be able to see that.
Can he see it?
Yeah, I'm just following his hand, so...
Okay, we have a question. Does it have support for an external monitor?
No.
Drive?
No. As far as monitoring goes... Actually, that's a good question. We'll just do this.
Separately?
Yeah, it's better just to have a camera there and have the voiceover.
We can do that
later.
No, we don't have to worry about it.
Okay. As far as the monitor... Who asked that question?
Drev?
What's up, Trev? As far as the external monitor, because we're foregoing the dual-handledness, it's going to be harder for you to have a dual monitor. But that being said, it doesn't mean you can't do it. So there's two things that you can do. One, you can see the GH5 over here. We have this side monitor flip-out screen with the GH5 has. And with that, it's become much easier as far as monitoring and just framing everything. Now, if you do want to attach a proper monitor like a Pixie 5 or a small HD, because of the quarter 20 on the bottom, you can attach a rail going this way, and then probably, I would say, a tripod ball head, and then you can use that down here. Problem is you're probably going to have to hold it in such a way because there's a bar sticking out this way. But I would think it works. We haven't actually tried it, but considering all the HDMIs are here and then going straight down here, you might actually be able to do it well. Or if you're really crazy, you have a bar here, you have a bar here, so you're holding onto two bars and then your monitor is sitting right there. I don't know how that would work, but that's something to think about.
Talk about it through the camera too. This way we have it. That we cannot use.
Oh. All right, Drive, I'm going to say the exact same thing, but towards that way.
The other thing you can do is because they are so small, mm-hmm. It doesn't block the views in the back. I mean, you still can see that you don't really need an external monitor.
Okay. Well, he might be recording the ProRes, though, to like an Animus Shogun or something. Possibly.
MOZA is do not sell a cold shoe that screws onto the handle, but you can get a magic arm.
Wait, what?
He was asking whether the MOZA sell an accessory to attach it.
A monitor?
Oh yeah, you can always attach the door handles. Yes. Yeah, you can continue.
Okay.
I can type this out.
Okay, sorry. Talking about the external monitor thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. I should probably I'll say it and you can keep it in the edit if you want to. Alright, so this review is actually being This review is being broadcasted live right now, and we actually do have some live questions. So one of the questions was, can we attach an external monitor to the single-handed gimbals because they're not dual-handed like we used to? And the answer is yes and sort of, kind of. We haven't really tried, but I'm going to explain it. So right now on the GH5, you see that it has a flip-out screen. So if your DSLR has a flip-out screen, you can pop it right out to the side so it's not covered behind the motor back here. And that should help you get a better framing. That being said, the A7S doesn't have it, but because these gimbals are so small and they're basically right in front of your face now, you can see the screen still just fine. But if you're using an external monitor as a recorder, there's probably one way you can do it, and I would assume that it works, but I haven't tried. What you're gonna do is there's a quarter 20 on the bottom. You can either have a magic arm or you can have another quarter 20 rod come out this way, what have you, and then you can have the monitor faced here on a tripod ball head. Because the HDMIs are generally on the left side of the camera, it's got a nice short distance to go instead of wrapping through everything on the dual handle to get to the monitor. That being said, if you're using the MOZA Air, you do have the option of attaching the dual handle system and therefore run the gimbal like it used to be back in the day when we didn't have the single-handed gimbals.
Back in the day, I feel like we're so old.
It is back in the day. Okay.
It was like only 2 years ago, really.
So the iOS app we will talk over through a voiceover thing. The time-lapse feature. All right. Okay. One of the cool features that comes with the MOZA Air is there's actually a time-lapse feature. Now, what that means is that you can go into the app on the iOS, the Android is coming a little bit later, but what you can do is you can tell the gimbal to hit certain points wherever you tell it to go. It goes up to 3 points, I think.
Okay, I think it's five.
Is it five? Can we double check? It was quite a few.
None of the gimbals on.
On, but it's not on the A7S. So, now, for my live viewers, if you weren't with us in the beginning, you do hear quite a bit of rumble right now, and that's because we need to go into the app and tell the MOZA Air that this is a very light Sony camera, and once we do that, the rumbling will stop. There you go.
Time lapse. Okay. They need to give you the little set point. See the camera? I'm actually controlling the camera right now.
So right now,
It is being controlled through the MOZA app.
5 points.
And there is 5 points to the time lapse. Okay, cool. So can you move the camera back? All right. Cool. All right. One of the cool features of the MOZA Air is there's actually a time lapse feature. Now you can access this time lapse feature through the app, which is on iOS right now. The Android version is coming soon. And so basically what you can do is you can program the MOZA Air to hit 5 very specific points and how long it takes you to go through those 5 specific points. Now, if you're a GH shooter like we are, there's already a built-in time-lapse feature in the camera, so now we can do these really cool sweeping panning moments of like a cityscape while the clouds are flying through it, you know, very reminiscent to stuff you see on Breaking Bad or something like that. So, if you are a photographer and you love to do some motion time-lapse thing as well as video, the MOZA Air is going to give you those capabilities. Okay. How much is a thumb controller from Zhiyun?
$35, but it does not have all the feature.
Yeah, it's just a remote.
Yeah. Up and down, left and right. Okay. Focus.
Okay.
To be sure, I'm going to double check now.
Okay, stand by. Any questions that you saw Vitas come through?
The only one about the different choosing of the camera, but I already responded.
Okay.
They're talking about the app.
About the app?
Yeah, choosing the camera and the app so you turn off the vibration.
Oh.
Is it?
Wait.
Is it a drop down in the app for different camera models?
Is there a what?
A drop down.
In the app.
So, yes.
Oh, who asked that question?
Merda? Yeah, I already responded.
Oh, okay. As long as he...
Remote $35. I was right.
Okay. All right.
You can turn that on, too.
What?
You can turn that on once you get ready.
Now both of these have an accessory that you can purchase, which is a wireless remote. Now on the MOZA Air, it's very reminiscent of the wireless remotes you saw in their gimbals in the past. This is going to run you $199, and the Zhiyun Crane is going to run you $35. Now I know what you're going to say, why is one more expensive than the other? Well, the reason is the Zhiyun Crane, all you're going to be able to do is go up, down, left, right, and that's it. That's all you can do.
A little more than that.
Okay.
It can do. It has a joystick, and they can do zoom in, zoom out, on and off. Yeah, up and down, left and right.
Can you record?
You do not say. Most of it could be able to record too, but it does not have a feature of selecting the cameras or weight.
Right. Right.
Or adjustment of follow focus, follow tilt, and minor basic adjustment.
Okay. Now there's an additional accessory that you can purchase with both of these cameras, and that is a wireless remote. Now for the MOZA, you're going to be able to get this wireless remote for $199, and then for the Zhiyun Crane, it's going to be $35. Now I know you're going to ask, why in the world is this one so much more expensive than the Zhiyun Crane? Well, the Zhiyun Crane can do all the basic functions, so you can go up, down, left, right, on, off. You can do the zoom for certain camera brands. Whereas the MOZA Air, not only can you do all of those, but there's also a set of features inside here. So if you don't want to pull out your cell phone app, you can use this to change which camera body you have, the weight of each setup that you have. There's also the ability to do calibration as well through this remote. And of course, like I said, in the back here, you have the rocker to zoom and zoom out on Canon lenses.
We'll probably show the video of the MOZA has about the thumb controller.
Yeah.
There's quite a few there.
What else we have?
The last thing is conclusion.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Maybe we should tell ask each one of you guys and see which one you guys like prefer.
Actually, that's true.
Okay. So for this test review, we actually did quite a few things. We had experienced gimbal runners versus the ones that are not experienced gimbal runners. And of course, we've done, as you saw through all of this, we did a test on the Nikon D70, which is basically our Canon 5D, if you will, full frame DSLR. We've had the nice mid-size range, which is our GH5s, running with those lenses. And then we have our lightest setup, which is the A7S. So real quickly, we're going to bring them over to in front of the camera, and they're going to tell you their experiences of running these cameras real quick.
Keith.
Just all three of you.
Go. Speak louder. What do you like of each of this gimbal, whatever?
No.
That's okay. We had to shut down my...
Are you sure?
Yes.
Make sure that's enough. I'd rather than have good audio.
Okay.
So you want to... You're doing it in front of the camera, too.
It's just like, you know, running with it, what you thought. Because you're an experienced gimbal runner, so you can just, yeah, or hold this so it doesn't fall off.
So just hold this up.
Yeah, just, you know, you could talk about ease of use, whatever. You can explain who you are too.
My name is Keith Collins, and I am. My name is Keith Collins, and I am a user of both of these gimbals. I like them both equally. Both of them were very good. This one felt a little heavier in compared to this one. Also, this gimbal here seemed quicker to set up, but both of them were still very easy to use.
What kind of camera do you use?
The camera that I use most of the time is the Sony A7S.
Well, tell who you are first, right?
Yeah. My name is Dennis. I don't...
You're a filmmaker?
Yeah. I'm Dennis. I'm a filmmaker. And I pretty much only worked with this one here. It seemed to work pretty well. I don't know how much that's just... Because I don't know the difference between the two. There did seem to be, like, as far as, like, the tilting, like, when it had to pan over, that seemed somewhat delayed sometimes, but that... could just be me not operating it as much as you guys have. So I guess that's it. You have any? No.
So you only use the
I only use this guy, so I don't have a comparison between the two. So I don't know if we can really provide.
Yeah, I use both.
Okay. Special. What about you, Linus?
So he used the MOZA.
Well, it's okay. It's still just in general, like using it.
So he used the MOZA.
Okay. My name is Vitus. And I typically use a Nikon D750. I'm not really all that familiar with, you know, working with gimbals, especially, you know, single handheld. I've, you know, rarely even seen them. In between the two models, the MOZA and, how do you pronounce
crane.
This? The Crane?
Yeah.
Between the MOZA and the Crane, I don't really see that too many differences. There is a slight weight difference in between them, and response is maybe a little bit different, but it's not noticeable for me, you know, being not too
familiar with
gimbals.
Cool.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, we got to talk about the tracking.
Yes, tracking, sorry.
That was for drift.
The pattern drifting, the heading of the gimbals.
Would you know peaking?
Oh, I don't know. I thought you had the peaking on. Okay. Well, I guess that's part of the conclusion, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Any questions?
Nope, so far.
Nope, so far? Do we even have people still here?
Yeah, 8 people.
Oh, cool.
Is Franz still there?
Franz, don't... Don't bail on us, buddy. You've been with us from the beginning. Give him a second to respond.
Say, yeah, it'll take about a couple of seconds.
He's probably still here, which is awesome. He gets the gold star.
Team Franz.
Team Franz. Hashtag Team Franz. Okay, conclusion. We'll talk about the handling for Drev. And guys, while we're going through the conclusion, as far as like, we're going to be talking about handling, we're going to be talking about, you know, which ones we think is good for certain people, depending on your setup. If you do have a question and we want to run into the in the conclusion of this video review, go ahead and just type it down, and our team will let us know if there's a question we should talk about for you. Okay? So in conclusion, between these two gimbals, I have to honestly say they pretty much perform just about the same. Now, the handling of each one, with the MOZA Air, there's definitely a whole lot of fine-tuning you can do within the app itself and also the desktop app. So you can make the tracking and smoothing faster or slower depending on your shooting style. So for me, I like to have the tracking nice and slow. So when I make the movement, it's going to slowly follow instead of immediately going to where I point it. But if that's the kind of footage you're trying to get in the movie you're trying to make, then you can do that. It does follow quite quickly when you set it to its maximum standard. As far as the modes you can shoot in, just very much similar to all the gimbals, you have the all locked mode, so no matter what you do, it's just going to keep the camera focused on right in front of you. Or you can have the follow modes that will go up and down, pan left and right, or you can just have it only pan left and right while you're following your subject. In terms of everything else, like I said, the build quality of both of these are quite good, and the reason I'm going to say that is because we actually took this on an action movie shoot, my film, and we ran with these things really, really fast, probably more fast than people would be comfortable with, and we did take a tumble each time, a couple times, and both of these gimbals held up, because again, they're made out of solid metal. And they did a wonderful, wonderful job in capturing those running moments for the film. As far as battery life goes, again, that shoot was an 8.5 to 9 hour day, and we used it extensively for all those running shoots, and the gimbals did not run out of juice. We didn't actually replace the batteries, we just charged them and went. So as far as how long can they last, they lasted basically an 8 hour shoot. Were they on the whole time? No. But chances are when you're shooting those kind of films, you're not running them continuously for 8 hours. So from what we can tell, on a normal shooting day, they were just fine with the batteries they had. That being said, these batteries are quite cheap to purchase. So if you do need another set of batteries, it's not going to cost you an arm and a leg. What else?
Which one do you prefer?
Which one do I prefer? That is going to be largely... Sorry, this is more for that. So now comes the question, should you get the MOZA Air or should you get the Zhiyun Crane? So here comes the question, should you get the MOZA Air or should you get the Zhiyun Crane? Honestly, because they performed so similarly, it's going to be hard for me to say which one over the other, but what I will say is it largely depends on what you're shooting and what you're shooting with. So if you do shoot with, let's say, the Nikon D70, the Canon 5Ds, or any cameras that are heavier, you're probably going to want to go with the MOZA Air because it handles up to 5.5 pounds. And having that flexibility of adding more weight, because, I mean, lenses are changing all the time. And if you end up with a heavier lens, you're going to want to make sure you have enough power to run it. If you're running with mirrorless only and you pretty much already know what you're going to do as far as your lenses go, maybe you just have that one lens you like to use, the Zhiyun Crane is a really good option, and this is why. The Zhiyun Crane is, once you get it balanced and you turn it on, it just works. Like, there's not a whole lot of tweaking you have to do. So it's kind of a little bit better in that sense. But like I said, there's really no one size fits all situation in terms of shooting. So I would actually probably go with MOZA Air just a little bit more because you can have that fine tuning up to your shooting style. Whereas a Zhiyun Crane, it's kind of just your run and go.
Cool. I think that's it.
Hold on.
Sanjiva, thank you
for watching. There might be one more thing. Oh.
We're hungry. We want to go eat.
Yeah, I do too.
Sorry.
And lastly, if you're going to really look at it from, you know, what are you getting for the money kind of point of view, then the MOZA Air is going to definitely be the best bang for the buck, because not only are you getting the gimbal itself, you're getting a more powerful motor in case you update to a heavier camera in the future. You're getting the dual rod system if you do require that kind of running setup. Maybe you don't always have to, but if you do, you know the option is there. And yeah, I think that's it. That's it. As far as I'm seeing. Yeah.
Mark would say thank you. Brian's asked what did I feel got hurt. Brian's still well.
Oh.
David,
what's up, Brian?
Like BTS live stream.
Behind the scenes live stream.
So yeah. Do a thank you and check out whatever.
Okay. All right. So this was our very first time doing a live stream of a review, and thank you viewers for popping in your questions and everything like that. Your input definitely helps because we want to make sure we give you the most comprehensive review. That being said, I think we'll probably do this again, except next time we'll actually let you guys know when it's going to happen so that everyone can tune in and we can give you the best review possible. That being said, I want to thank everyone for watching, and we will see you in the next one.
Press finish and upload.
Good.